So this is pretty much just the intro day to probability, right?
Probability. For instance, we have this list of cards here. They're not fancy. I didn't write them all up with like the symbols. But if I was playing a card game, say we were playing 21. Anybody know how to play 21 in here?
Okay, good.
So let's say if it was only me and the dealer. So they're just dealing to me only. And right now I have, let's see, I have a jack, I have a four. What else do I need to get 21? 10? Base cards are 10. Plus 4, 14. So how many more do I need? 7 more. So if I have to get a 7, what is the probability of getting a 7? Let's see. So, if it was only me, it's the first deck. It's the first deck they're playing to me. So, it's only the dealer just playing to me. I'm seeing if I can get 21. So, we already have some kind of jack. We'll say it's the jack of spades. So, I have the jack of spades already down. Let's say it was four diamonds. Doesn't matter. Four diamonds is down. Okay. So, now I have to get a 7. How many 7s are there?
4.
So, there's 4. How many... altogether, there's 56 cards on this board, but I took some cards away. So how many are left over in the deck after these have been dealt?
54.
So the chance of getting a 7, if I have a jack and a 4, it's the first deck that's been dealt here, is 4 out of 54, which is 2 out of 27, which is basically about 1 out of 13. So is that a really good chance or not a good chance?
No.
Not that great a chance, right? So when you're playing card games, you're doing game theory all the time. You're doing basically trying to predict what the future is going to hold, how many positive options there are. You guys do this all the time. By the end of this unit, you're going to be able to do that with some more complicated scenarios, right? So if you are, trying to get into some internship program, you know your numbers, you know the things that you've done. You can figure out the probability that that certain internship is going to work out for you or not. Okay, so you can do this with a lot. In essence, it's going to give you all these options. If here's my choice and I have this many options for it, it's going to allow you to cancel out the options that aren't very likely, aren't probable. Okay, so probability has to do with, in some ways, it's kind of fortune telling. It's trying to tell what the future is. You know, as your best estimate of the future. So all this today, this is all the vocab in the background in order to start probability and talking about it with the same language. So let's look at it. Okay. Set. A set is just with these brackets, and it lists all included items. All included items. So I want you to create a set of odd numbers from rolling a six-sided dice. I should say that. So we got six-sided dice here. I want you to make a set, make a new set, we'll call it set A, of odd numbers from rolling the dice. Go ahead and fill that in right there. Really quick, and then check with your neighbor. So I need odd numbers from rolling a six-sided dice, odd. Yeah, and check with your neighbor. What are all our odd numbers on a die? Yeah, that's not one.
I don't know.
But
it was the 1, 5, 3.
All right, let's see. Veronica, what are my items in this set?
1, 3, 5.
Perfect. Anybody else get that? You guys got that? Some of these questions are going to be very easy.
I like these.
Just don't stop listening because that one seemed easy. Over here, it's a little bit trickier. Not too much. So that's a dice. We know that if I was looking for the probability of getting these three numbers, it'd be 1 out of 2. It'd be 50%, because that's half of the numbers. Now, this is a sample space or universal set. It's just all the possible outcomes. So the sample space, all right, guys, I want you all to do well in this lesson, in this unit. Sample space. I legitimately do. Not all teachers actually do. So I want y'all to focus here, please. All right. The sample space is all the possible outcomes in the dice. So you see here, sample space, 1 through 6. Now we're going to create two new sets here. This one is going to be, set B is going to be rolling a number greater than 2. I want you to go and fill in set B from this sample space of the dice. Rolling a number greater than 2, go ahead and fill those in right here. And then if you want to go to the next one, C is going to be roll an odd number less than 3. And remember, it's the sample space. The possible options come from a dice. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let's see. Violet, what should go in our set B? Yeah? How about in set C? Set C, yeah. This young. What? Sometimes a set is boring. It only has one thing in there. In this case, it's 1. Okay. So the odd number is less than 3. Don't worry if it's like the set is really small or huge, right? Because you're going to get those scenarios. Okay. So far, so good. In the next weeks, the next days here, we get more complicated with this slightly. All right, let's look at this. Complement. All right. So let me ask you, because you guys are the dating experts. Right? Do you look to date someone that's exactly like you? Exactly like you?
I don't look to date.
You're awesome. I didn't play like you. So what do you look for? If when they say somebody compliments you well, like you're a good couple, you compliment each other well, what does that mean? What does it mean if someone compliments you well? Not like gives you a compliment.
It goes well.
Goes like well. Flows. So where one person has a weakness, the other person might have a strength. Yes. One person has like an interest in something, the other has another different interest. Or complementing each other is kind of like the yin and the yang, right? One fills in the other. It helps you complement each other. Because if you date someone that's exactly like you, then your life can only be as good as your life is. Right? Someone that compliments you, might get different parts of life to experience. So look, a compliment, just like if I needed someone to compliment me, I'd want them to have the things that I don't have, right? I want them to have the things that I don't have so that we can together be stronger. So not in the set. This compliment, this little dash mark here, is how we know if we look for the compliment. So make sure that dash above the B, the compliment is denoted by, this is the complement of B. So all this is the same. The sample space is here. Here's our set B. Go to fill in what the complement of B is. Looking at set B, what's the complement? What does set B need in order to complement each other? So what do you think? 1, 2. I look to set B. The complement of B is the values that are not in there. So this is all the possible values. 1 and 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That would get all the numbers. It's like code. This is set theory. It is actually like algebra 2. It's even higher than that. Set theory is tricky stuff. But you have to know the same vocabulary. Otherwise, I throw out, hey, what's the complement of set B? And you don't have the wording. So today it's just like, we're getting the wording down. Okay, easy games. All right, these two are our last two. These are the main things for today. Okay. So a union are all the values in both sets. So you see here, you may see this listed this way. This is our sample space, R, just listing the whole space. We have set D. D's are the 3s, the 4s, and the jacks. Okay. Set E are all of the hearts. Okay. So if I am looking for this new set of D union E, let's see what that means. So let's get rid of these. Set D includes 3, 4s, and jacks. So I'll have these for you tomorrow. You can work on together in partners. But just to keep it going here. So let's see, D is 3/4. And the jack here. All right, what's the other? What's the other set? All of what?
All
the hearts. So I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna take all the hearts. And for a little bit of convenience, I'm not gonna make you write out the set for every single one, like 3 of spades, 4 of spades. It's gonna take a long time. So we're gonna go this way. We're gonna say the union is all of them. Because we had this from set B, we had all those from set E, so the union between them includes all of them. It's like this Venn diagram. If we have set D and set E, it's all of them together, and that is the union. Union just means all of them. So like all the teachers belong, are in the union. The union includes all the teachers from all the schools. So this one I would write in here as the 3s, the 4s, the jacks, and all hearts. Okay, that's union right here. We got them all. This and we'll get another one. I had this one down here going, but I can't do this. Rebooting. All right, here we go. Notice also union. U. The symbol looks like a U. So D union with E. D union with E. What's this? It looks like an N. It's actually like a U upside down. Yeah, I think of it as an N because it helps you remember. Intersection. The intersection and N. I like mnemonic devices to help me remember because there's so much. But it's just the U upside down. That's our intersection. So this is the items at the intersection. So it's going to be the things in common right there, right in between the two sets. So set F is all clubs. Set G includes all the sevens. So, I don't know why I wrote that down. Okay. So what would F intersection of G be? Let's look. Okay, what is set F? Set F? What is included in set G? All set.
1, 2, 4.
So if I'm looking for the intersection between F and G, where do those two sets intersect? What's in common? Because we had all the sevens. We had all the clubs. So where they intersect is what we're looking for. You know, at times, if instead of all the sevens, it was all the sevens, all the jacks, all the twos, then we'd have more than one item in our set. But what goes right here? Seven. Clubs is hard to draw. Seven clubs. Okay. All right. How about this? The last one. We have set M, and that's hearts, and we have set N, that's diamonds. And I want you to do M, intersection, N.
Oh.
What goes in that set? Let everyone think about that for a second. What goes in that set? Don't intersect. This is going to happen sometimes too. Sometimes the set answer has nothing included. It's an empty set. When you have an empty set, nothing is included in the set. Go to put the empty set.
Oh.
You don't have to write anything else. do a couple of examples, then I'll set you loose for classwork. Let's see. Yeah, that's what I did. Okay. No, that one's boring. Let's do this one. Let's change up what these sets are. I want you to please find, let's say this is hearts. These are threes and nines. Three, sevens, and nines. Oh, I forgot how to make a break. Great. All right. I want you to find the intersection of M and N, please. Too easy or too hard?
Visual.
So let's do it. Right? You'll have these tomorrow to work on at your desk. So let's see. All the hearts. All the hearts. And then what else?
Threes.
Threes.
Seven.
Nine.
Nine.
Where's our intersections?
Nine, seven, three.
Good. Three heart. Seven heart. Ace counts as one, or 11, but I put it as one, just because there's like one heart on it. It just made sense to me. I want this, but where I can draw all over it somehow. Laminator. All right, let's see if there's anything else I need to show you. Actually, that's about it. One other thing. If your answer had a redundancy, like it was 1, 2, 5, you only have to list each item once. So I wouldn't make two twos in my answer. I'd make it one of the twos. You're showing how many representations of the numbers are in there. Thumbs up, sideways, down, first day.
I like this.
Yeah, it's different brain, use of the brain. All right, guys, let's go ahead and do the classwork. It's in the workbook.